I'm going to start with a little story. Once, there were two blindfolded physicists that had to identify the animal in front of them. The first one touched a cylinder-like object and thought it was a snake. The second one touched a hairy tail and thought it was a lion. It turns out the animal was an elephant. As often happens, if you only have local information about your surroundings, you fail to see the bigger picture. This is a big problem in quantum field theory. The main idea of this theory is that nature is made out of these objects called quantum fields. Unfortunately, just like the elephant, these fields are way too big. They're infinite in extent. So how can we, tiny humans with our tiny devices, ever learn about the big picture of a quantum field? Luckily for us, the universe likes to shake our quantum fields. Let me explain this. Imagine now that the elephant, our quantum field, is made out of tiny puzzle pieces. When a quantum field becomes stable, when it thermalizes, all its information gets scrambled. The universe shakes our puzzle. This is really helpful because now, if a physicist only has local information, they will see pieces from the tail, the legs, the ears of the elephant. If they're smart enough, they will identify the elephant. In our case, though, unscrambling this local information about quantum field is a little bit more difficult. We are definitely not smart enough. Thankfully, computers are. This is where our research comes in. We are applying artificial intelligence techniques to translate this local information to general properties of the quantum fields, like their topology, their entanglement. So far, we can detect tiny changes in faraway points of the field using only local information. This research contributes to the ongoing quantum information revolution. Just like a few decades ago, we processed information with transistors to make our computers and our phones work, now we can use the information in quantum fields to improve quantum computers and even build new technologies. Last but not least, this research will deepen our fundamental knowledge about the universe. Sometimes it's a great idea to study the elephant in the room. Thank you very much.